Recorded 6 CDs. Tell me how they've all differed, the past from this one, Lay It Down.
I think Lay It Down, the biggest difference from the last 5 is probably, at least from the last 3, Michael on this album has taken up the lead guitar role, which he did on the first 2. And so that's making it different. Also, it's a lot sparser.
What inspired the lyrics on Lay It Down?
Well, Michael's the writer, and I think he gets inspired by all kinds of things. I think books, definitely, he reads a lot. Life, meeting people on the road especially, and hearing their stories.
So he writes the lyrics, but then you give them life. How do you make them your own?
Well, I think there's 2 things. Firstly, I think, As a singer, I'm a storyteller. I mean, that's my job, is to give the song meaning or make it believable. So you just do that by expressing how you feel, what you think the song is about. And secondly, I think Michael, as a songwriter, is totally egoless. When he gives me a song, he truly gives me the song. He doesn't tell me how he wants it done or tell me what he meant by it, so he truly allows me to take it and to interpret it in my own way.
Your singing comes straight from the heart, it's so emotional. Is it hard to get it to where you want it? Did you lessons, practice?
In the early days, I didn't take lessons because I felt that my style was, just as you said, was just based on sort of being natural about it and just doing it and not thinking too much about it. And I was afraid that lessons would make me think more on the technical side than the emotional side. After our last album, Pale Sun, Crescent Moon, I began to feel more confident that I could hang on to the natural side of my voice and also learn some technique, which I really needed to learn. So I did take some lessons for this album and will continue to. It's really opened up a lot, and I still feel I've retained what makes my voice different.
Tell me a little bit about the recording and how, what's his name, John Keehan? How did he influence your CD?
Well, John's the first producer we've ever used. We've always recorded our own music. We were nervous about it, and he came in and sort of said, listen, all I want to do is capture your music the way that you do it. I don't want to tell you how to do it, and I don't want to change it. And so it allowed us to play our music and feel free that what was going down onto tape was what we wanted.
Is it difficult working together because you're family, or does it bring you closer together?
Well, definitely it brings you closer together, because, you know, here we are, we're all in our 30s, you know, when brothers and sisters are usually living their lives separately with their individual families and only coming together at Christmas or Thanksgiving or something. A lot of the experiences that we have, we're able to really share in the same way because our values are the same and our morals and where we came from. Working closely like you do in a band where you're living together day in and day out, it's going to be hard with anybody because it's very close. But for me, it's easier because they're my brothers. I can tell them how I feel, or I can understand how they feel without even hearing. And I know how to give them space, and I know how to slap them around a bit when they need it, and vice versa. And I think that's what keeps us sort of grounded in this industry, because it's a strange world to work in, and I think they keep everything kind of amusing.